What's up, guys? We're back for another video. I'm Mitch.
I'm Brandon.
And I'm Hunter.
And this is the Look for Today.
Today, we're gonna be out here showcasing our concealed carry guns, kind of giving you guys some pointers on these. So I got my Springfield XDE right here, and then Mitch has his...
I've got the Smith & Wesson Shield 2.0.
So we'll be kind of showcasing these today. We're gonna shoot some targets, have some fun, maybe bring out something cool at the end here, so.
Yeah, stay tuned.
Stay tuned.
Yeah, so we're hanging out right here on Hunter land, 15 acres out here. It's kind of wet, you know, a little bit today, but we're gonna shoot some targets. We're gonna have a good time.
Well, let's get to it.
6.1 inches long with a 4.5 inch height, and that's with the flush mag. With the extended mag, it's 5 inches. More narrow than the XDE at 0.99 inches in width. It because it's only a single action, it has a 5.5 inch trigger pull, and the capacity is a 7+1 or 8+1 with the extended. Kind of a $350 to $500 range, depending on what attachments.
All right, so right here we have the Springfield XDE. It is 6.75 inches in length. It has a 5-inch height, and it's 5.25 inches long with the extended mag in it. It has a 1-inch width. This pistol has a 5.8 pound trigger pull for the single action, and a 11 pound trigger pull for the double action in there. It has a great grip, a really crisp hammer for pulling back, and the slide feels great too. The gun typically runs you between $500 and $600, depending on the caliber, obviously attachments you get for it.
All right, guys, we're about to get ready. We're gonna take out these watermelons. Safety's off. Here we go. I missed. That's it.
You.
Good.
Hey guys, now we're gonna shoot the Springfield XDE. Let's see if I can hit the watermelon a few more times than Mitch did. Not a single shot. Oh well. All right, we're gonna try this again. Let's see how this goes. I could not hit that little thing.
No!
Oh my goodness.
All right, guys, if you haven't already, make sure you check out in the description. You can follow us on social media, me, Lakin, Michaela, Honor, Brandon, Mason, all of us. You check it out.
Come on now.
When we play it back, we'll never.
All right, shoot it ready? Go.
Huh? I'm scared.
Is your fingers on?
No, it's like down here.
Yeah, okay, good. Yeah. Just don't want to rip your finger off. There it is.
All right, my tongue.
It's still ready. You still got a couple rounds.
Still?
All right, guys, we're gonna do the concealed carry test now. I'm gonna draw it as quick as I can and see what I can hit over there.
Right to left.
We'll see about that. We'll try again.
We'll try again.
All right, you guys are probably wondering at this point in the video what gun is best for concealed carry and what shoots better. And the answer to that is...
smash that like and subscribe button.
No, but that's up to you guys to figure out.
All right, I'm gonna do this conceal and carry test.
Tougher than in the movies, man, I'll tell you.
Hit one, I didn't even hit one yet.
Are they going to check it out?
Yeah, you got that one.
Oh yeah, baby. Damn. Oh yeah. Oh, oh, oh. Oh my.
Look at that.
She's one of the only ones that's hit a target so far, so.
Yeah, there we go. Entry, entry, entry. Get those exits. Guns are dangerous, kids.
Very dangerous.
Safety first.
Woo!
Safety.
Always use safety.
Safety first.
Yes, sir.
Ready to roll.
This man's ready.
All right, guys. So we're a little sick of missing targets here. So we're gonna do a real concealed carry test, because in a real life situation, you'll probably only be a couple feet away from the person that is trying to attack you.
This is gonna be point blank. We can't miss.
Hopefully not. The watermelon we're going for is that big one right there. That's a realistic target. They're gonna be a few feet away from you. So we'll see what we do. We'll draw and shoot at it. So
we'll see what happens.
Hope you guys enjoy.
3, 2, 1, go. Oh.
Clear.
You're good. 3, 2, 1, go.
Woo!
Clear. Clear.
All right, guys. This is what would happen to an attacker. We recommend concealed carrying if you take the right classes for it, do all the safety things, do everything right, learn your gun.
Yep.
This is the way to go.
Just be responsible. That's it. Live for today. All right, guys. We said we had a surprise for the end of the video.
This is the surprise.
We're gonna blow away some watermelon. All right, shotgun's loaded.
You're gonna feel it.
One, you bitches.
Wow, this is nice. Is it ready? Just pull the trigger.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh gosh, I feel like it's gonna jerk me so bad.
You got this, Lincoln.
Yeah, buddy. No, it wasn't that bad.
Let's see the watermelon damage. Show it off on her.
Split that thing in half.
Oh yeah.
That was probably the fall, but.
Yeah. She got nailed. Here we go.
Yeah. Woo.
Yeah. I have one more in my pocket. But...
All right, guys, so we are back after shooting, and as you saw, everyone kind of got a chance to test out the different guns, see how they felt, how they fired, and honestly, how they felt, too. So, Brandon, what is your kind of first thoughts?
I mean, they're both pretty similar, honestly. When you buy a 9mm pistol, I mean, it's going to be, they're going to kick the same. They'll, you know, depending on the brand, they'll aim the same too, from what I understand, because I, you know, I'm not a complete expert on these yet, but from what I can tell, you know, both guns are pretty similar. Mitch's is a little bit smaller, so maybe easier to conceal. Mm-hmm. The only difference between mine is that it has a hammer and it does hold an extra round, so it does do 10 with one in the chamber in there. So, but if you're a good shot, you won't need those extra rounds, you know. So,
and what Brandon said about that, the hammer, you know, I like how my gun is striker fired, meaning it doesn't have that external force. But this just feels so crisp when you lock that slide back. It's actually very satisfying.
And honestly, it's just your preference, because striker fire, hammer fire, at the end of the day, they both do the same thing. So it's really just, you know, whether your preference to not have a hammer on the back or if you like pulling that down on the back before you shoot, so.
Kind of, what are your thoughts?
Yeah, both guns were similar in weight, similar in kick, similar in the loudness of that shot. But I mean, I would say maybe Mitch's gun, he had a little bit of a wider grip, made it a little bit easier to, you know, nicer hold in the hand. But other than that, very, very solid, both of these firearms right here. So they're both great options. Choose what you like. Mitch's, it's a little smaller, might be able to conceal better depending on what kind of clothes you wear. But, you know, if you wear looser shirts, pants, you know, you'll be able to conceal both of them, no problem. So. Yeah. And it's really your preference.
Ultimately, when it comes down to concealing, it's going to be what's comfortable for you and works for you. So these are just two great options.
And as always, guys, we recommend getting your license first, taking all the necessary training,
yep,
playing it safe. You know, these are not toys. So.
And if you noticed, all day, we've all been wearing some kind of safety glasses or ear protection.
Safety first.
Mm. All right, let's see what the girls have to say.
All right, Michaela, what was your favorite gun today and why?
Today, I liked the shotgun. It was really fun and really powerful.
I kind of liked Brandon's gun just because it doesn't have a big of a kickback, but I do like this, how small the size of holding the gun. Mm-hmm. So, but the shotgun was a lot of fun. I enjoyed it.
All right, guys, I hope you liked today's video. I hope you guys got a better understanding of what a concealed carry type gun is and ultimately what's going to work for you.
If you liked the video, comment below with any additional stuff you'd like to see us do, and be sure to like and subscribe. And remember, guys, live for today.
Woo! See you next time.